Welcome back to the continuing series of working with Scribus. In this lecture, we are going to talk about working with layers. To start, we have to know what layers would be useful for. And I would say one of the most common things that I would use layers for is when I have a background and I want that background to be visible through objects. So I would create the default or first layer, which is what is created when you open up a new Scribus document. And for most projects, that may be sufficient. You don't need a second layer. But if you do have objects that you want to have the background show through, then you would want to create additional layers for different objects. There are other reasons for creating layers, as we'll see as we go along, but for our intents and purposes, that is probably the most common. So let's look at a layer. We will go to Scribus. We will open a new document, and as usual, we have a single fold. And now, by definition, you see this is a layer. So we would work on this as the background layer. To open up a new layer, go to Windows and then go to Layers. Or as you can see, you can also hit F6. And the Layers window will open. And on first appearance, it looks very simple. But as you see, as I go through each of these explanations, it is a very powerful tool. At the top of the window, you see we have blend mode and opacity. And note that we've discussed these already in other contexts, but what we can do with these tools is apply a blend to the entire layer and apply opacity to the entire layer. Now for the background, which as you see is the only layer we have here, for the background that doesn't make sense. Normally in background we would want it to be normal and 100% opacity. But then as we build layers on top of that, we may want to change that. So we'll work with that a little bit later. All right, and then on the bottom you see we have the tools to add and delete layers. Notice that you cannot delete the background layer, so the only thing we can do at this point is add a new layer. So the new layer here, we can rename it by double clicking on it. So let's just call it layer one for now. And then if I wanted to, I could delete that layer too by clicking on the delete sign. And then the final three tools here, I can use this button to duplicate a layer. I could use this button to move a layer up. And I can use this button to move a layer down. So right now, I can't execute layer up because layer one is at the top level already. But I could lower it to be below the background. And of course I could duplicate it if I want. So that's what these buttons are used for. Now let's look at the other buttons. When you create a new layer, you get a color identified with that layer that uniquely identifies or helps you identify the objects in that layer. You can go and change the color if you want just simply by clicking on the color, and the color choices will come up to you if you don't want the default that Scribus assigns to the object or to the layer when you create a new object, a new layer. So adding another layer, you see now we have automatically a new layer with a new color assigned to it. The next button, the Make Layer Visible button, is used to hide or show layers from the display. So for example, if I had a layer that I didn't want to show in the final product, but say it had comments in it or something that I only wanted to see within the program and not within the final product, I could then go in and hide that layer here just by simply clicking on the box. So clicked means show, unclicked means hidden. The next button pertains to printing. And one of the things that you need to be careful here is when you hide or a layer from the display, that does not mean that it will not be printed. If this box is checked, that layer will still be printed or it will still export to a PDF file. So if you want to have a hidden layer in your document that also is hidden in the print version of that document, then you should unclick this button as well so that the layer is not printed or exported to PDF when you get to that step in your product production. The next button, the lock button, lets you lock all objects on a particular layer so that they can't be edited, moved, or anything like that. They are, you might want to say you finish a layer and you don't want to make any more edits to it or accidental edits, then you can lock that layer and nothing can happen to that layer after you've locked it. Now let me explain the next button. This button here is make text in lower levels flow around. We already talked about how in the text, working with text lecture, how we can make text flow around an object in that same layer. What this button does is it allows you to put objects in higher layers. For example, what I was talking about at the beginning, where you might want to make the object be opaque and the background would shine through that object. But you can, if this button is checked, then text at the lower level will still flow around an object at a higher layer. The final button here is the outline mode, which toggles the wireframe display of objects to speed up the display of complex objects, say, for example, vector graphic objects that are typically slow to load. And if you toggle this on or off, then you can get the graphics to load faster because they don't fully load. So it's turned off here because we don't have any. But if I had a graphic in a layer that was taking a long time to load, I would turn this on so that it loads faster. Of course, when you print it, it would produce the full graphic, but it doesn't have the it loads faster on screen if you have this option clicked. Obviously, it makes sense only to have it turned on if you add such graphics to your layer. The next topic is how do we move between layers? As you can see here, we now have three layers. We know that this is the layer being displayed because this is the line being displayed, but how else can we tell? Say if this layer box was not open. All right, now what layer are we on? Well, the status bar here at the bottom of Scribus always tells us what layer we're on. And also, it's a pull-down menu, so it can be used to move between layers. So, say I want to go back to the background layer, then I can click on that, and now the background layer is being shown. So, you need to check that all the time to make sure that you're on the layer that you want to be working on. And it is also the way to toggle between layers. Another thing you might commonly want to do is to move an object from one layer to another. So, for example, right now we're on layer one. Let me insert a shape. Pick a triangle, or sorry, a rectangle. Let's give it some color. All right, now, how do I move this from one layer to another? I can click on the item, so it's already highlighted, and I can go to item and send to layer, and then you see I have my choices of which layer to send it to. The other thing I could do is right click on the item, and I also get the send to layer from the context menu, so I can send it to a different layer. And now when you look on the background, you see that it's on the background layer. Now when I'm working with objects and layers and I send an object to another layer, how do I know which layer the object's on? Well, your document design should help you. In other words, if you're going to be using layers, you probably should have a good plan, such as the text goes on the background layer, the objects, images, whatever go on their own layer, and then maybe if you want, you'd have, say if you're putting together a newsletter, you might have your headings and titles on a third layer so that you can work on with them independently. But you wouldn't create multiple layers normally with multiple objects unless you're doing something very special. But say that does happen and you lose track of which layer an object is on. Well, one easy way is, if you see here, the properties box is grayed out. So that tells me that object is not editable on this particular layer, even though it's showing here, because I have opacity set so that it shows through. Also, if I try to click on it, nothing happens. If I go to the layer that the object is on, when I click on it, it gets highlighted, and also the properties box is not grayed out anymore. So that's how I know what layer the object's on. Now, one last thing I want to share with you comes from the Scribus Wiki. These are hints for working with layers. First, it's important to note that layers always exist for the whole document, not per page. So if you add multiple pages to a document, you still have the same layer structure. And then if you want to select all items on a layer, you can use the Edit Advanced Select All from the menu bar. If you're deleting a layer with objects on it, you'll be asked if the objects should be removed as well. If you say no, then the objects will be moved to the background layer. Scribus also supports layers in Adobe Illustrator files, but only if the AI file is being opened through File Open. If you import a layered AI file via Import, then all the layers will be merged into one. And one final note is that layers are supported in PDF version 1.5 and later, but you need Adobe Reader 7 or higher to display the PDFs correctly. All right, so those are just some of the hints that we have for working with layers in Scribus.